Dollars, cents, how much something costs when you use it. How do you know when you're dealing with the cloud? Microsoft's got an answer for you when it comes to Azure, and I'm going to tell you all about it coming up now. Hello, my name is Adam Gordon, entertainer here at ITProTV, and I'm going to be your guide for our What is Azure serial. In this episode, I'm going to tell you about what the Azure Pricing Calculator is. Specifically, I want to walk you through three really, really important questions. What is the pricing calculator? Why would you want to use it? And of course, most importantly, how do we get our hands dirty and actually play with this thing? Let's begin by talking about what is the Azure Pricing Calculator. When we think about the Azure Pricing Calculator, what I want you to think about is three specific things when we think about what it is. First of all, it is a tool. Most importantly, it's something we can use that helps us to understand what the cost of one or potentially more Azure services and features are. You ever have to fix something at home and you're rummaging around in your toolbox trying to find that right tool for the job? Well, the Azure Pricing Calculator is that tool. You have a question, you need an answer, and this is the tool that's going to help you figure it out. It does so by allowing us to create what are called scenarios, stories that allow us to explain to ourselves, to our customers, to stakeholders, managers, people that may be interested in what this service is, what it's going to cost, how we're going to use it. Lets us tell those stories and figure out exactly what that ultimate cost will be, and to show people that have to make those decisions, make those investments, exactly what they're going to have to spend to get the benefit of this service. And finally, when it comes to understanding the cost, getting the benefit from the scenario, I want to think about estimates, the actual example of what this cost is going to be laid out for us in an easy-to-understand document, line by line, just like we'd expect a good estimate to be. And as a result, allowing us not only see the individual cost of a service, but the all-up cost associated with the service, the support associated with it, the licensing if there is any, and perhaps more than one service because we want to bundle them together to solve a complex problem. That estimate we're going to create, or that the tool will allow us to create, is going to show us all of that. So these are the reasons that help us to understand what the Azure Pricing Calculator is and what it can do for us. Let's talk about why we want to use it. Why is it so important? Why would we spend the time? Well, you can see that the reason we spend the time is that it's going to help us to understand all the things we just talked about, but it's also going to help us to understand how to show and tell those compelling stories. Showing and telling is always good, right? We want to share things with others, want to explain to them and get them excited about the concept, but clearly articulate what that value proposition is. And by doing so, hopefully allowing everybody to understand that we're making a good investment and doing so in the most efficient and also the most effective way possible. And finally, we want to answer the most important question: how do we actually use this thing? And for how, let's take a look at the tool. You could see here, we have a tabbed interface. We have four tabs moving left to right. Let's start with the products tab. You can see we have a search area. You can type in the name of an Azure service if you know what it is. We have an ability to navigate in a kind of a categorized view that's going to just have boxes that then bring up these tiles that you see all over here on the right, things like virtual machines, storage accounts, etc. And as we scroll down, you could see there's a list of different areas where if I click, everything changes, and I can choose whatever service or feature or any combination that I want to be able to make up my estimate. But I'd have to know all the different products doing it this way and add them incrementally. And I may or may not know all the products I want to use to form my solution and solve my problem. So we can also go ahead and use what's known as the Example Scenarios tab, the second tab over. This tab allows us to use pre-built scenarios that Microsoft's put together, bringing together a lot of complex services to create a package that solves a specific business problem, perhaps something like advanced analytics with big data, as you can see, or perhaps creating a modern data warehouse or some sort of continuous integration or continuous deployment solution for containers with DevOps, as you can see. We have a lot of different options. One, more or less, that'll probably fit our needs. Let's say we chose real-time analytics or advanced analytics, whichever one we choose, the picture changes. You'll notice we get a workflow that explains to us how these products come together, how they fit with each other. And over here on the right, we also have a list of all the products and services that make up this solution. And now, if I choose to add this right down here to my estimate, I can do that right down at the bottom here on the right by clicking that button. I'm going to have this estimate with all of these services and features already built out. I don't have to worry about remembering to get all these together. They're already there. And you can see I've clicked on this button because you'll see real-time analytics is listed right down here. And as we look at this estimate, it's built out. All of the details and services are here. I can open each one to see more detail if I need to. And you'll notice that we have both an upfront cost column, third column over, moving to the right. No upfront cost for us right now, but I do have a breakdown line item by line item for monthly cost on each of these areas, these services, these aspects of this solution. I total all that up down below, but not before I add in potentially additional support and perhaps additional licensing and other programs I may want to combine here. I have that option. When we're done, we come down to the bottom. We get both our estimated upfront and estimated monthly cost as line items. You can see off to the right, we're at about $9,300, almost $9,400 US here. But notice I have the ability to export, save, and share, as well as at the bottom on the right, I can purchase and integrate my solution right here, going direct to Microsoft and beginning the acquisition process from the same page if I choose to. We like the fact we can export this out as a spreadsheet, save it and use it later, or share it directly from the website with others who may need to be involved in this conversation, helping us to make the right purchase and ultimately the right choice about how much money to spend. If we did click save, potentially, right, you'll see we can do that, but you'll notice it says log in to save our estimate. I mentioned that we would benefit from having an Azure account, although we don't have to have one to use this tool. If we log in, we're able to save our estimates and call them back up later. I do this with customers all the time, so I can refer back to their estimates if they need them. When we think about using the Azure Pricing Calculator, we want to make sure that we get the full benefit of this. So never overestimate and never overlook the ability to pull back up that estimate that's been saved on the tab and use it as a go-forward strategy to refer to over time. I'm going to be your host for our entire Azure serial as we take a look at what is Azure. So you'll be joining me for all sorts of exciting conversations, look at different aspects of services, how they work, and of course, answer those questions that are really important. What is it and why do you want to use it? Until we come back with another episode, if you need more training, more insight, or generally just more knowledge about Azure and how it works, join us over at ITProTV. We've got plenty of Azure training. You'll see myself, along with many of my colleagues, helping you to understand all the things you want to know to make the most sense and get the most benefit out of your Azure investment. Until I come back with another What is Azure episode, I'm going to wish you happy Azuring, and I'll see you soon.